Hello, camera campers. Welcome back to Kinoteca. Today, we're talking about color grading Fuji X-T4 footage using Film Convert Nitrate in Premiere Pro. Quick disclaimer, I am not a professional colorist. Yes, DaVinci Resolve is an absolutely wonderful high-end professional video color grading master tool. The reason I'm using Adobe Premiere Pro is because, one, I'm used to it, and two, I create a lot of content. I release multiple videos a week, and this is just my quick workflow that I've learned. And honestly, I like Premiere Pro. Sorry, sue me. So we're gonna start with this footage of a music video I shot this past summer. And this is a good example of a high dynamic range scenario. Obviously our highlights are blown out in the window, but that's fine because freedom. First thing we're gonna do is grab ourselves some Film Convert Nitrate. We're gonna drop this on the clip. And now we're gonna choose our camera, obviously. So we are shooting with the Fujifilm X-T4 in F-Log. That's what we shot all of our footage on. And boom, that's a great starting point. The reason I don't use transform LUTs, like the Fuji F-Log to Rec. 709, is because I just don't feel like I need them, and I don't like the look that they give me a lot of times. You could totally use the transform LUT and then put Film Convert on top of that if you want, and then you would just, I think you would just do the default settings like this because it's a lot softer here. But since they have the option to use your camera pack, I just do that and I like it. The very first thing I do is I take all the grain out of the footage. Grain is cool, but lately I've just been really liking clean images. I don't know, it just feels good to me. Plus YouTube's compression kind of eliminates grain anyway, so I don't feel the need to add a bunch of extra stuff that's not even gonna be seen. If your exposure is totally wacky and like really bad, try using this exposure slider from Film Convert because it's honestly amazing. Like this slider, you can get a lot of information back. It looks pretty good in the window, honestly. Obviously, it's way too dark on our subject, and that's what we're prioritizing here, but it's a powerful tool that you can definitely get some good results with. Keep that in mind. Now, I wanna just cycle through all these beautiful film stocks that Film Convert offers us. And this is the reason that I do not use LUTs. I don't like really using LUT packs from any creators or random ones on the internet. I'm sure there are some great ones out there. This is like the heavenly host, a beautiful choir of LUTs that look filmic. I'm probably making no sense. So what I do is I put my mouse over this little thing here and use my scroll wheel to just go down through the different presets and pick one that makes me happy. If you wanna see me do this exact same thing but with this Sony a7S III, go to my personal channel, Zach Mayfield. I'll link the video here and at the end, but I'm doing a little color grading tutorial for both cameras because I like them both. The FJ8553ET is making me the most happy right now. My eyeballs are cheering in gladness, so we're gonna rock with this. Now, if your skin looks wacky, we will go into a way where you can totally isolate that and change it and make it correct. But right off the bat, you can mess with this film color adjustment and sometimes make your skin look a little more natural. Basically, I think this is the intensity of the film stock on your footage, from what I understand. So if your shadows or highlights are totally crushed, you can mess with this slider a little bit. We could pull down to like 80% instead of 100, and then use the color correction sliders here to get our contrast back if we need to. These highlights are pretty much just gonna go anyway, so we're gonna get them as close to 100 as possible and then just let them hang out there. Another thing I like to do is punch in to look at the small details of the face and add some softness if I need to. This image doesn't look too sharp to me. I think I was shooting with an 8th Pro Mist on this shoot, so I'm not gonna soften it up at all. But the a7S III, the other video I did, is a super sharp sensor, so I actually typically add like 5 to 10% softness on that camera. It's up to you though. Do what you want. I'm not gonna tell you what to do. So below our little sliders here, we have this wonderful saturation adjustment, and this can be real fun. Basically, I just crank it up until it looks way too intense, and then slowly dial it back until my eyes say, there you go. Typically 120 to 130 is where I like mine to be, because it kind of like flavors up the colors without it looking too punchy or weird. Below this is your basic curve adjustment, so you can totally customize your exposure and isolate certain areas of the image. Sometimes if I have really blown out highlights, I'll add a little curve like this to soften them just ever so slightly. You can see it kind of just fades them out. It kind of adds a little bit of a little Pro Misty look. The Film Convert sliders, these guys here, do a pretty good job, but sometimes I just don't like how they interact with the footage. I don't know what exactly is going on, but for some reason, I prefer using the Lumetri color sliders. So I'll drop Lumetri below Film Convert, go to color wheels and match, and then I'll use these because it feels like they just adjust the overall exposure a little better than these film convert ones, which seem like they isolate the highlights, which is good in some situations if you just want to pull the highlight exposure down a little bit. I don't want to make him look too contrasty and punchy, so I'm just going to kind of keep his lower end a little bit higher. To me, this is looking pretty good so far. Obviously, I'm not the best colorist in the world, but I mean, this was our starting point. Now here's where we're at. This is a very challenging shot to grade because one, I'm not a professional, and two, it's just an intense dynamic range situation. It's really challenging our camera. And I probably could have brought the exposure on set up a little bit on him so that there wasn't too much of a drastic difference between the highlights outside and inside. So this is just a way for me to learn how to shoot better as well. Now let's say his skin looks totally whack and you need to fix it. There are a couple things you can do. So down in the curve section, you can go into these and start pulling values out and adjusting things. This blue one in particular, if you pull it down, it kind of accents more of the orange because it's pulling blue out and those are complementary colors. But if you're happy with your overall image and you just need to change his skin tone, I'll show you how to do that. So we're gonna add another Lumetri color below this and we're gonna go to our HSL secondary. And then down here, this is where the magic happens. You see this set color thing? We're gonna biggity blam, use that, smack that on his face, hit show mask, and now we're gonna fine tune these to just be selecting his face. And we want it to be a nice even mask. So obviously there are some spots that are missing because they're different color tones. And we don't want any weird color patterns to show up. So what we're gonna do is go to this blur setting. And I usually add 25 or 30%. It adds a softness to that mask. So if you change the skin tone, but one part isn't selected, it's not gonna make this one part look all weird and blue or green or whatever. It just makes it nice and smooth. Since we have our mask selected, our scopes over here are gonna show us exactly what's being selected. So if I turn it off, it's the entire image. If I turn it on, it's just the skin. So we can see that our skin tone is riding this line here, which is what we want. This is referred to as the bloodline, which shows the saturation of our blood or our skin on the scope. So if you want to correct your skin tone, you go into this big wheel here, click and drag to the area that you want to change it to. If we want natural, we're obviously gonna go right along where that bloodline is. So the farther out you go, the more saturated it is. Obviously, it's gonna start looking crazy. And now we'll turn our mask off. So that's what it's looking like. It's a little too orange, but if we turn it off, we can see the difference there. Also, you can change the saturation by using this here. Here's 100. Let's see what 90 looks like. So I'm gonna go to my shadows and pull those down. That's looking pretty good to my eye. I think that looks really sweet. So here's before, now there's film convert, exposure adjustment, skin tone adjustment. So let's say we wanna go one step further and you wanna look like Hollywood. You want the teal, the orange, the whole shebang. I'm not the biggest fan of that, and I'll get into that a little bit later when we color grade one more image. What you can do is take this Lumetri that we just did with the skin tone adjustment. You can copy this, Command C, and then Command V, and it's the exact same thing, but what we can do is invert the mask, so now it's selecting everything around his face. I'm gonna change my saturation to 100, make it normal, and then obviously we don't want the background to be the same color as the skin, so you can add that teal look here if you so desire. And here's before and after. Before, after, before, after. It's just a subtle hint of teal. I honestly don't really like it in this scenario, but that's how you do it if you want to do it. So the reason I don't really like adding teal into my shadows is because you can get that naturally by shooting during a blue time of day. Right after sunset, you get like, I think we had a 36 minute window or something like that where everything looked very blue. This is looking very intense right off the bat, but let's just dial through our different film stocks, pick which one looks good for us. I really like this one, the FJ AST100. We're gonna go with that for this X-T4 shot. Obviously our skin tone doesn't look orange, but that's not really what we were going for. We wanted this to look really moody and blue. So this would probably be a good scenario to use our color curves. So we're gonna go down here. I'm gonna immediately just bump up our saturation. If we pull a little bit of blue down from the midtones, our skin looks a little bit more natural, but we still get that blue vibe. So here's before, after. And this is the reason I don't like using LUTs that just put a ton of blue in the shadows, is because you can get that naturally by shooting at this time of day, and it still looks organic. It doesn't look like you dialed the blue way up. So now if we wanted to get even more specific on this shot, we could go through and isolate his skin tones and make them look exactly how you want. But I really like how they look in this shot. I think they look great. I could add that mask to his skin to make sure they're sitting on the bloodline. In this particular shot, now that we have it masked, you can see his skin tones aren't very saturated at all because it's blue hour. So if we wanna add some color to his skin, we can just use that same tool we did last time. Let's see, before, after. Just a little bit of skin tone color brought back into the shot. I'm really happy with this shot. The X-T4 is such a beautiful camera, man. It looks so good. I really hope this was helpful. My brain is completely fried. If you have any constructive criticisms or tips for me, let me know. If you learned something, let me know. Let's chit chat in the comments. Thank you for being my beautiful little camera campers. Have a wonderful week. Subscribe, do all that stuff. We'll see you next time.